Hi folks, CodeTutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande.
Welcome to the another new series that we will be starting with this particular video. From this video onwards, we will be starting a series on how to work with the dependency injection in a typical Android application. So before we are starting this particular series, we have come through a quite a journey. Just before a couple of weeks back, we were going through various dependency techniques. We have understood what is dependency injection, what are the different types of dependency injection. And now, having understood what are the different types of dependency injection, we are very well poised to start exploring how to apply the dependency injection in an Android application. And to get started with, we will start applying manual dependency injection. We will not be using any dependency injection frameworks like Hilt, Dagger, or Koin. So it would be a very plain vanilla dependency injection. And once we have a very basic understanding of how this works, then we will move on to the actual implementation using DI frameworks. So let's get started. The code that we will be using to do this is the pretty old same application that we have been going through for quite some time, which is a country info application. If you are completely new to this, let me just quickly show you what the application is all about. So this is the same application code base that you have been seeing through the dependency injection series and solid principles series. Let me just run this and show you what the application is all about. If you see here, it loads some country specific information. It has a flag of the country and then general information about it. Then you can filter it by continent. And if you double click on it, you can edit the capital of the country. And if you do a long click, you can delete the country. So nothing fancy. And we have built this particular application as per the solid compliance. If you actually go through the individual classes, interfaces, it is all compliant with solid dependency injection principle. Let me just go to the country repository. Everything is being passed as the constructor parameter. So it is compliant with dependency injection principle and solid principle. If I can show you the overall dependencies, this diagram should give you a pretty good idea of what the dependency looks like. So you have a main activity uses country info app scaffold, and it uses UI view model and operation view model. And then this UI view model is dependent on other things. But if you come to the country view model, country operation view model, it uses repository, and this repository in turn uses some kind of a service provider and a country DAO. And country DAO in turn uses app database, which is a room database. There are two implementations of this particular component. That is country list service provider via network, which basically fetches the country list from a REST API call. And then this one basically fetches it from a local JSON file. So depending upon how you want to use, you can use either this or this one. And if you come down here, this uses in turn a retrofit framework to do the REST API call. So whatever that you are looking at, the depiction of these dependencies looks like an inverted tree. If you can consider this as a root, then these are all the different branches and nodes. And that is the reason why this is called as a dependency tree. So even though it looks like we are using proper solid principles and our application is already very well refactored with proper solid principles, there are still certain things that we will have to refactor in our code to make it more compliant with dependency injection. Between the line number 47 to 53, you see quite a number of classes here. They are not being passed as argument to country info app scaffold. You are defining country DAO here, service provider here, repository here, and then you are initializing all those things here. So this is in a way not a explicit dependency injection. So we don't want to use the dependencies like this directly in a composable. Of course, you could move this particular instantiation into the main activity here. You can define all those things here in the main activity and then pass it as a argument. But once again, the problem is all these dependencies are splattered all over code. So we need to have a better mechanism of implementing a solution that passes these dependencies in a much more cleaner manner. And since we want to do the dependency injection in a manual way, we will use something called as app container based dependency injection. Now, what do you mean by container based dependency injection? So to understand this, let's give you an analogy. Think of your application as a motorbike. Now, this particular bike has a lot of dependencies if it needs to work perfectly fine. For example, it needs different set of tools. Tools such as brake, oil, chain. If something goes wrong, you need a wrench, spanner. So bike basically has dependencies on all these different set of tools. But you can't simply throw these tools everywhere. These are very necessary and you need to manage it in a proper manner. So a best practice would be to put these tools into some kind of toolbox. But once again, you don't keep this particular toolbox anywhere. Most likely you have some kind of a workshop and that is where you keep this particular toolbox. So now with this particular analogy, let's try to understand where the container comes into picture. If you think your bike as a application, then all these tools that you need for your application to work perfectly fine are dependencies. And the toolbox that you use to keep these dependencies is nothing but the container. So that is where the word app container comes from. Now, what is the workshop? Workshop is nothing but your Android application class, the class that extends application. So with this understanding, let's try to implement the app container based dependency injection, which is nothing but manual dependency injection. So what we will do is we will create a class called as app container. Let's create this here under this package app container, and this basically needs the context. Then we need to basically put all the dependencies in this particular app container. Going back to the analogy, we are going to put all the tools in the toolbox.
That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.